Hi friends, good evening. Welcome to Shankaran AI Study Circle. This is Dr. Harinath Reddy, Director of the Institute. Today in this particular video, we will try to discuss about strengthening the institution of Election Commission of India. So then what is the background or the backdrop under which this topic has become very important? Remember, this is useful for a UPSC Group 1 mains exam, APPSC Group 1 mains exam, TSPSC Group 1 mains exam, and even to some extent to the TSPSC and APPSC Group 2 exam. So what is the context? So when the elections were held to the state of West Bengal, there were allegations against the Election Commission of India that it has acted partially towards favoring the political party which is in power at the level of union government. So these were the allegations which were leveled against the Election Commission of India. So keeping this in mind, there is a compelling need for strengthening the institution of Election Commission of India. Remember, one important reason for the success of Indian democracy is because of the role played by Election Commission of India. So the Election Commission of India, has conducted free and fair elections to the parliament, to the state legislatures, office of the president and vice president successfully for the last 70 years. So we had even state election commission. So what is the difference between Election Commission of India and the state election commission? Election Commission of India conducts elections to the office of president, vice president, parliament and the state legislatures. State election commission conducts elections only to the local governments, rural and urban local self-governing institutions, that is the Panchayat Raj institutions, the municipalities, municipal corporations and Nagara Panchayats. And there is no relationship between Election Commission of India and the State Election Commission. Election Commission of India, it was created under Article 324 of the Indian Constitution. Then State Election Commission, it was under Article 243K. It was created under the provisions of the 73rd and the 74th amendments to the Indian Constitution. So in the beginning, so this clarity between the role of Election Commission of India and the role of the State Finance Commission must be kept in mind. Then, to make the institution of Election Commission of India autonomous and independent, the Chief Election Commissioner, the Chief Election Commissioner cannot be removed straight away by the president. If you want to remove the Chief Election Commissioner, the removal motion must be passed both in Lok Sabha as well as in Rajya Sabha with a special majority. What is this special majority? A majority of the total membership of the house and a majority of 2/3 of the members present and voting. So this is the majority with which even the judge of the Supreme Court is removed. So the Constitution of India says the Chief Election Commissioner can be removed on the grounds and in the manner like the judge of the Supreme Court is removed. So the judge of the Supreme Court is removed on the grounds of proved misbehavior and incapacity. So similarly, the Chief Election Commissioner can also be removed on the ground of proved misbehavior and incapacity. And this man can be removed only by the parliament. The two in the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, a special majority is required. So I told what is that special majority. A majority of the total membership of the house and also 2/3 of the members present and voting. So to some extent, this guaranteed the independence of the working of the Election Commission of India. Though the Chief Election Commissioner is appointed by the Union Government, he cannot be removed by the Union Government. He can be removed only by the parliament, that too with a special majority. So this guaranteed the independence and autonomy of the working of the Election Commission of India. And this was responsible for the conducting of free and fair elections in this country and thereby protecting democracy in India. Remember, Election Commission of India is one of the best election commissions across the globe. And many election commissions across the globe, they look to the Election Commission of India to follow the Election Commission of India. Despite this, there are certain gaps. which need to be corrected so that this institution can be further strengthened. For example, in the removal, yes, there is a security of tenure to the chief election commissioner. The other election commissioners, they don't have a security of tenure. Similarly, when it comes to the appointment process, there are problems. For example, when Naveen Chawla became the chief election commissioner, there were allegations that Naveen Chawla was associated with the 1984 Delhi riots. So we need people of highest integrity and ability to occupy the Election Commission of India, because the Election Commission of India performs the most important constitutional duty of superintendent's direction and the conduct of elections to the parliament, state legislatures, to the office of the president and vice president. And even in the recent past, I told, when elections were conducted to the legislative assembly in the state of West Bengal, there were again allegations that the Election Commission of India did not act in an impartial manner. So when such allegations come, then that will be dangerous to the institution of Election Commission of India in terms of its independent working as well as autonomy. And that is a situation, and that is an opportunity to further strengthen the institution. If you see the Constituent Assembly debates, in the Constituent Assembly debates, there was one suggestion. What was the suggestion? Especially when it comes to the Chief Election Commissioner. When the Chief Election Commissioner is appointed by the Union Government, there was a recommendation that this particular person must enjoy the confidence of all the political parties in this country. So, after appointing a Chief Election Commissioner by the Union Government, it must be confirmed by the Parliament, both Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, in a joint session by 2/3 majority. So that was one recommendation in the Constituent Assembly, but this was not accepted. Today, the Chief Election Commissioner and other Central Election Commissioner, they are appointed by the Union Government straight away. There was no selection committee for such a purpose. So the President will elect, the President will appoint the Chief Election Commissioner and other Central Election Commissioners on the recommendations of the Union Council of Ministers headed by Prime Minister. But compare this with others. For example, if you take NHRC, National Human Rights Commission, the chairperson and the members of the National Human Rights Commission, they are appointed by the President on the recommendations of a selection committee consisting of 6 members. The Prime Minister, who acts as the chairperson, the Central Home Minister, leader of opposition in the Lok Sabha, leader of opposition in the Rajya Sabha, Speaker of Lok Sabha, Deputy Chairman of Rajya Sabha. So these are the 6 members in the selection committee. On the basis of the recommendations of this selection committee, the chairperson and members of the National Human Rights Commission are appointed. So this will ensure, if there is a broad-based committee on whose recommendations the chairpersons and members of the NHRC are appointed, this will ensure the right kind of persons are to be appointed as the chairperson and members. Similarly, for example, if you take Lokpal, the anti-corruption agency of the Union Government, so the chairperson and members of the Lokpal are again appointed by a 5-member selection committee. The chairperson and members of the Lokpal are appointed on the recommendations of a selection committee consisting of Prime Minister as the chairperson, Speaker of Lok Sabha, leader of opposition in the Lok Sabha, Chief Justice of India or a judge of the Supreme Court nominated by Chief Justice, and an eminent jurist. So the chairperson and members of the Lokpal are again appointed by the President, not on the recommendations of the Union Government. But on the recommendations of a broad-based selection committee consisting of Prime Minister as the chairperson, Speaker of Lok Sabha, Leader of Opposition in the Lok Sabha, then Chief Justice of India or a judge of the Supreme Court nominated by Chief Justice of India and an eminent jurist. Similarly, take other examples. When it comes to the Director of CBI, the Director of Central Bureau of Investigation, here again, the Director of CBI is appointed by the President on the recommendations of a three-member committee consisting of the Prime Minister as the chairperson, Leader of Opposition in the Lok Sabha, Chief Justice of India. Similarly, the Central Vigilance Commissioner, CVC, he is again appointed by the President on the recommendations of a three-member selection committee consisting of the Prime Minister as the chairperson, the Central Home Minister, and then Leader of Opposition in the Lok Sabha. Similarly, we have Central Information Commission, which is created under Right to Information Act 2005. So, in the Central Information Commission, the Chief Commissioner and other commissioner, they are again appointed by the President on the recommendations of a selection committee consisting of Prime Minister as the chairperson, Leader of Opposition in the Lok Sabha, and then one cabinet minister to be nominated by the Prime Minister. So like this, with respect to the Lokpal, with respect to the National Human Rights Commission, with respect to the Central Information Commission, with respect to the Director CBI, with respect to Central Vigilance Commission, the members, chairperson are appointed by the President on the recommendations of a broad-based selection committee. So, a similar mechanism must be instituted for appointing the Chief Election Commissioner and other Central Election Commissioners, because this will ensure that the right kind of people can be appointed as the Chief Election Commissioner as well as other Central Election Commissioners. For example, the Law Commission of India in 2015, in its 255th report, the Law Commission of India in March 2015, in its 255th report has recommended that the Chief Election Commissioner and other Central Election Commissioners must be appointed by the President on the recommendations of a selection committee consisting of the Prime Minister as the chairperson, Leader of Opposition in the Lok Sabha, and the Chief Justice of India. So this was one very important recommendation made by the Law Commission of India. Then subsequently, we had a second ARC, Second Administrative Reforms Commission, in its fourth report. Has recommended that the Chief Election Commissioner and other Central Election Commissioners shall be appointed by a five-member selection committee consisting of the Prime Minister as the chairperson, Leader of Opposition in the Lok Sabha, Speaker of Lok Sabha, Deputy Chairman in the Rajya Sabha, and a Central Law Minister. So this is the recommendation made by second ARC. Then way back in 1990, Goswami Committee, which was appointed on electoral reforms, has also recommended that the Chief Election Commissioner and other election commissioners shall be appointed by the President in consultation with the Chief Justice of India and the Leader of Opposition in the Lok Sabha. This was a recommendation made by Dinesh Goswami Committee in 1990. And in 1990, there was a Constitutional Amendment Bill, 70th Constitutional Amendment Bill, which was introduced in the Parliament in 1990. there was a constitutional amendment bill which was introduced in the parliament known as 70th constitutional amendment bill to ensure that the chief election commissioner and other central election commissioners are appointed by the president on the recommendations of a broad based selection committee. But this constitutional amendment bill was withdrawn in course of time. So these are the reforms which are needed when it comes to the appointment of the chief election commissioner and other central election commissioners. So this will guarantee further independence and autonomy in the working of the Election Commission of India. Because as of now, the chief election commissioner and other election commissioners are appointed by the union government. So there is no guarantee that the right kind of people are always appointed in the context of the allegations against the Election Commission of India in the recent past and even allegations against Naveen Chawla earlier before. So then let's move to the removal. Here again, the students shall keep in mind the weaknesses or the gaps which will undermine the independence and autonomy of the Election Commission of India. One is the chief election commissioner alone enjoys security of tenure, because the chief election commissioner can be removed like the judge of the Supreme Court. If you want to remove the chief election commissioner, he can be removed by the parliament by passing a removal motion with a special majority. So if the parliament passes a removal motion with a special majority, that is a combination of absolute majority plus 2/3 of the members present and voting, then on the basis of this removal motion passed by parliament, president can remove the chief election commissioner. So this will no doubt will guarantee the autonomy and independence in the working of the chief election commissioner. But when it comes to the other two central election commissioners, they do not enjoy the security of tenure. They can be removed straight away by the president merely on the advice of the chief election commissioner. And this is not fair, because at the state level, we do have a state election commissioner. The state election commissioner enjoys greater security of tenure compared to the central election commissioners, because the state election commissioner can be removed like a judge of the High Court, and a judge of the High Court can be removed by the president on the basis of the removal motion passed by Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha with a special majority. What is that special majority? A combination of absolute majority plus 2/3 of the members present and voting. So the two central election commissioners, they do not enjoy the security of tenure which a state election commissioner enjoys. And again, if you see an ordinance which was brought in 1993 to a law made by the parliament in 1991. So in 1991, the Indian parliament has passed a law with respect to the service conditions of the chief election commissioner and other election commissioners. So this 1991 law said the chief election commissioner, 1991 law, I am telling the 1991 law said the chief election commissioner will enjoy the status of a judge of Supreme Court, and his retirement age will be 65 years. When it comes to the two other central election commissioners, they will enjoy the status of a judge of High Court and their retirement age is 62 years. But this was changed in 1993 through an ordinance amending the 1991 Act. So what were the changes brought? The status of the central election commissioners were made equal to the chief election commissioner. In other words, through an ordinance in 1993, the 1991 law was amended, and the chief election commissioner and the remaining two other central election commissioners will have the same status. They enjoy the status of a judge of Supreme Court, and all the three will have equal powers and their retirement age will be 65 years. So, if there is any disagreement among the three members of the Election Commission of India, including the Chief Justice, including the Chief Election Commissioner, the decisions are taken by majority. Fine. So, here the amendment which was done in 1993 through an ordinance also improved the status of the remaining two election commissioners on par with the Chief Election Commissioner. In addition to this, in TN session, Chief Election Commissioner versus Union of India, even in this case, the Supreme Court held that the Chief Election Commissioner and the remaining two Central Election Commissioners, they enjoy the same status. So, keeping this in mind, Law Commission of India has recommended, like the Chief Election Commissioner, even the two other Central Election Commissioners must also be removed, like the judge of the Supreme Court. So, as of now, the Chief Election Commissioner is removed, like the judge of the Supreme Court. Similarly, the two other Central Election Commissioners must also be removed in the same manner like the judge of the Supreme Court. So, this will further confer greater autonomy and independence in the working of the Election Commission of India, which will further protect and strengthen Indian democracy. In addition to this, there was one more important recommendation made by Law Commission of India. Here, Law Commission of India means I am referring to the Law Commission of India 255th report. Law Commission of India has submitted a report in March 2015. Law Commission of India has submitted a report in March 2015, 255th report. In this report, Law Commission of India has recommended the removal of the two Central Election Commissioners shall also be like the judge of the Supreme Court. In addition to this, if you see, as of now, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, they have got an independent secretariat, and the service conditions of the employees in Lok Sabha as well as Rajya Sabha secretariat, they are regulated by the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha themselves. So, now if you come to the Secretariat of Election Commission of India, the office and service conditions of the employees of the Secretariat for the Election Commission of India, they are regulated by the rules made by the Indian President. So, to impart greater autonomy and independence in the working of the Election Commission of India, Law Commission of India in its 255th report in March 2015 has recommended there shall be an independent Secretariat for the Election Commission of India, with the service conditions being regulated by the Election Commission of India itself. This was again a recommendation made by Goswami Committee on Electoral Reforms in 1990. So, that's it about the strengthening of the institution of Election Commission of India. So, in terms of appointment, in terms of removal, in terms of independent secretariat for the Election Commission of India, if all the recommendations which we have discussed now, if they are implemented, then the Election Commission of India will emerge as much more powerful institution with all the autonomy and independence which is required for conducting free and fair elections in this country, thereby protecting the Indian democracy and strengthening the Indian democracy. So, thank you.